it's not about integrity. It's more about the transparency. It's more about having transparency across the supply chain. Agri in India is not a new sector, right? Not, I mean, at least to any agri tech startup, irrespective of their model, whether it's back end, front end, lending, creating market, that's not a problem, right? That is something which has been existing. So then the important factor is the behavioral change. That's the important thing. And whatever or whichever technology interface we all are building, I think that's one thing we all always aspire that by using these interfaces, what sort of behavioral change we can bring. For example, in our case, I still remember during our early days, like in some area of Bihar, we encourage farmers to grow baby corn, right? They have never grown baby corn. However, they have been growing corn. And like in the evening, I was right there. And in the evening, I told them that, hey, so early morning, 5 a.m., 4 a.m., you have to harvest because we will be sending our truck. And then at 3:30 a.m., the guy called me again. Sir, are you sure? Are you sure I can? We need to harvest, right? Because the baby corn looks like very small, right? And they used to, they have been growing corn. So simple things, right? And I know I can go on and on, right? Most of the farmers across India, when it comes about irrigation, they go for flood irrigation, and that's a myth. It helps your plants to grow. However, that's not the right way, right? You can customize your extent of irrigation depending upon your crop, depending upon soil moisture, multiple things. So it's all about the behavioral change, right? And I think that's where, in our case, again, when in case of Dehat, like we always remain closer to farmer, and that's where the focus. I think having multiple touch point that really helps us. Because the same network of farmer, right? You are being with them throughout the year, around the season, not for a specific crop, not for specific services. So there was a consistency in terms of touch points, right? You're helping the certain network of farmers to get best source of agri input. You're also advising them. You're also helping them to sell their produce. Lot of information, and I think because of that, this behavioral change, could be seen in our model. I'm sure, like in case of let's say Vekul and Jacquard, of course, I mean to the same retailer or Kirana, if they are serving, the consistency is something, right? I'm sure which really might have helped them to ensure this behavioral change. And yes, the problem we all are solving, I believe, is the transparency, right? Because the sector, it has got a long tail, and because of the long tail, the industry holds bunch of inefficiency. And this transparency, it can be brought by technology. But ultimately, the technology has to be used by farmer, by our DC operator, by our collection center operator, or maybe our truck driver. And that's where behavioral change is
Got it. Got it. So, Prashant, you spoke about behavioral changes, and you spoke about the processes which need to be in place to ensure that the supply chain is running steady. When we say that there's a technology adoption happening for the supply chain, and to Sanjot's point, digital adoption in India is something which is underlying the entire disruption which is happening in agri. If you could talk about which are the stakeholders which are adopting this technology.
So if we map the entire value chain, which starts from farmers and ends to, let's say, consumer. So at somewhere in the mid of the value chain, and again, that's my belief and observation that people who are working at, let's say, wholesale level, or people who are working at aggregator level, people who are working at, let's say, even for the logistic, at that level, this technology adoption is very advanced now, right? I think so. That's not the challenge, right? So, for example, at least in our case, we have been creating our own last mile, network, right? Where we have close to 1,000 micro entrepreneurs now. At least now, all micro entrepreneurs, in fact, so they are very much comfortable with technology, and probably, and that's where you get you're getting the scalability. So between farm to consumer or between farm to businesses, I would say, like, the in the middle of the value chain where we have some sort of, aggregator kind of, people, maybe at for input, output, or whatever. I think at that level, the technology adoption has already happened. At farmer level, I believe that it's still a bit early. Smartphone penetration, that's not the right metric to look at, because most of the farmers have smartphone now, but still for them it's a device to make call and to receive call, or maybe to use Facebook and WhatsApp probably. Right. I mean, most of the farmers across India, they have been using app, but again, when it comes about transaction, they prefer to call you. So I think the technology adoption at farmer side, that's yet to happen. But the good part is that, yes, the way how smartphone penetration, the data penetration, that's increasing. You already said in the beginning of the call, yes, we started our journey. At that time, in fact, all farmers, they didn't have a mobile phone. Versus that, at least the silver line or the positive aspect is that at least now each and every individual farmer, they have a mobile number at least, right? So they all are very comfortable with the feature phone, calls, IVRs, on app, on payment gateway. I think that is something which is yet to happen. But we are seeing a very clear trend when UPI and gateways, all those things are getting strengthened. And we believe that again, and that's another reason why agri-tech startups in general in India is mushrooming up, right? Because the entire ecosystem is working in that direction.